Welcome online lecture series in wireless mobile communications. In previous lecture, we have seen the long distance fading, long distance path loss model, or we also seen the log normal shadowing. Now, this continuation, we have seen the fading. So, fading, we already know about the whenever the electromagnetic waves are traveling in a free space path in mobile communications, so signals experiences multi-path propagations. So during the traveling from sender to receiver, in between the rapid signals level of fluctuations is taking place in a small durations of times. So whenever the rapid fluctuations and are taking in a small durations time, that type of phenomena or process is called the fading. So fading is the cause which happening in the multipath propagations. So in mobile radio channels introduce the noise fading interference and other distortion into the signals that they transmit. So fading effect that characterize mobile radio communications are large scale fading and the small scale fading. So if there is a large number of multiple reflective path with the no line of sights signals path, it is the ray light fading. The ray light flat fading channels model assume that the channel induces amplitude which varies in time according to ray light distribution. When there is a dominant non-fading channels component presents, the small scale fading envelope is described by Riesian fading. So small scale fading results into the signal dispersion and the time variant behavior of the channel. Ray light and the Riesian fading phenomena include multipath scattering effect, time dispersions, and the Doppler shift that arises from relative motions between the the transmitter and the receiver. So the transmitter or in between the receivers, it affect on your received power. Received power. The major path results in the arrival of delayed variation of versions of the signals at the receiver. In addition, the radio signals undergoes scattering on a local or local scale for each major path. So such local scattering is typically characterized by the large number of reflection by object near the mobiles. So this components combined at the receiver and give rise to the phenomena known as multipath fading. As a result, each major path behave as a discrete fading path. Typically, the fading process is characterized by the ray light distribution for a non line of sight path and the Riesian distribution for a line of sight path. In mobile radio channels, the ray light distribution is commonly used to describe the statistical time varying nature of received envelope of flat fading channels or the envelope of an individual multipath components. The relative motion between the transmitter receivers causes the Doppler shift. The local scattering typically comes from many angles around the mobiles. This scenario causes the range of Doppler shift known as the Doppler spectrum. The maximum Doppler shift corresponds to the local scattering component whose direction exactly opposes the mobile trajectories. So multipath fading of signal received by the mobile unit is an inherent problem in mobile communication, as the as the location of mobile unit keep on changing in a real time, the resultant radio signal incident on its antenna varies continuously. The multipath in the mobile communication channel create a small scale fading effect, such as the rapid change in the signal strength over a small time interval or a small distance traveled by the mobiles. The random frequency modulation due to varying the Doppler shift on the different multipath signals and the time dispersion caused by the multipath propagation delay. The fading is the rapid fluctuation of radio signals amplitude in a short time or over a short distance. Actually, in reality, the received signal rapidly fluctuates due to the movability of mobile stations, causing the changes in the multiple signals components arriving via different propagation paths. So these multiple waves can combine constructively and destructively. Multipath waves are also generated because the antenna heights of the mobile unit is lower than the typical surrounding structure, such as the building, human-made buildings, up to urban areas of operations, and the operating wavelength is much less than the size of the surrounding structures at the mobile unit. The sum of multipath waves causes a signal fading phenomena. The rapid fluctuation of signal amplitude is reflected to a small signal fading, and it is the result of movement of the transmitter, the receiver, or the object surrounding them. So overall, the small area, the average value of received signal is considered to compute the propagation path loss and the received signal strength. But the characteristics of the instantaneous signal levels are also important in order to design receiver that can mitigate these effects. There are the two main reasons that contribute to rapid fluctuation of signal amplitude. The first, caused by the addition of signal arrival via different path, and it is referred to the multipath fading. And the second, caused by the relative motion of the mobile unit towards away from the cell site transmitter, is called the Doppler effect. The other factor that influence the small scale fading include multipath propagation, speed of the mobile, speed of the surrounding objects, and the transmission bandwidth of the signals. For a particular service area, the fading effect of received signal at the mobile station need to be analyzed towards the effect of the designing a reliable mobile communications systems. So, suitable diversity receptions or signal processing technique need to be provided to minimize the impact of the fading. So the multipath results in fluctuation of signal amplitude because of the addition of signal arriving with a different phases. So these phases difference is caused due to the fact that signals have relative different path length. Because the phase of the arriving path are too changing rapidly, the received signal amplitude undergoes rapid fluctuation that is often modulated as a random variable with a particular distribution is called Rayleigh distribution. So the multipath wave, as the mobile receiver bounce back and the due to the surrounding buildings and others effects. So the when a mobile unit is standstill, it received only the receiver and the signal strength at that spot. So the constant signal is observed when the mobile station is moving. The fading structures of wave in this space is received. So it is the multipath fading which become fast as the vehicle moves faster. So if we see the types of this fading, actually it is like this way. Types of fading. It is divided into two parts. One is large scale fading, another one is the small scale fading. So this is the small scale fading. This is the large scale fading. Small scale fading is further divided into the two categories. Multipath due to Rayleigh, multipath delay spread and second one is Doppler spread, and large scale fading is also two types. One is path loss due to path loss, and another one is shadowing. So multi-delay spread is also divided into two parts. One is the flat fading, and another one is the frequency selective fading. Frequency selective fading. Flat fading. This Doppler spread is divided into two categories. One is the fast another one is the slow. Bye. class trading, and this is the slow trading. अगर इनको इन सब चीज़ों को अगर हम वायरलेस पैरामीटर्स में ले जाएं, वायरलेस चैनल्स पे, कि देयर इज ए एक्स ऑफ टी इनपुट विच अप्लाइड इन वायरलेस एनवायरनमेंट इन ए फ्री स्पेस, फ्री स्पेस and we got the output y of t. So this is the input, ये मेरा है output, ये मेरा channel, वो भी wireless channel. Wireless channel, जिसको कि हम रिस्पॉन्स एच से डोनेट करते हैं, तो क्वेश्चन हो जाएगी आउटपुट वाई ऑफ टी, वाई ऑफ टी इज इक्वल टू एच product of h or input x of t. This h is known as response so let us see wireless channels. वायरलेस चैनल्स अगर हम स्मॉल स्केल ट्रेडिंग में देखें, क्योंकि इसी फ्री स्पेस में ही हमारे ह्यूमन मेड बिल्डिंग्स होंगी, माउंटेन्स होंगे, ट्री होंगे, लैम्प पोस्ट होंगे, गाड़ियां होंगी और नदी नाले ये सब होंगे. इनका इफेक्ट ट्रेडिंग के फॉर्म में कैसे पड़ता है, तो पहला जो पॉइंट होगा पैरामीटर ऑफ मोबाइल मल्टीपाथ चैनल्स, पैरामीटर ऑफ मोबाइल मल्टीपाथ चैनल. इसमें जो हमको पढ़ना था, जो देखना है, जो पॉइंट्स हैं, ये तीन तरह से हैं. एक है टाइम डिस्पर्शन पैरामीटर, टाइम डिस्पर्शन पैरामीटर, दूसरा पॉइंट है कोहेरेंस बैंडविड्थ, कोहेरेंस कोहेरेंस बैंडविड्थ तीसरा है हमारा डॉपलर स्पेड एंड कोहेरेंस टाइम। दूसरा जो पॉइंट है वो है फेडिंग ड्यू टू मल्टीपाथ टाइम डिले स्प्रेड फेडिंग ड्यू टू मल्टीपार्ट टाइम डिले स्प्रेड के अंदर जो पॉइंट्स हैं ये दो तरीके के हैं, एक है फ्लैट फेडिंग, दूसरा है फ्रीक्वेंसी सेलेक्टिव फेडिंग। फ्लैट फेडिंग दूसरा फ्रीक्वेंसी सेलेक्टिव फेडिंग। ये फर्स्ट और सेकंड पॉइंट है, तो थर्ड पॉइंट है हमारा फीडिंग ड्यू टू फेडिंग ड्यू टू डॉपलर स्प्रेड इसके अंतर्गत हमको देखने हैं फास्ट एंड स्लो फेडिंग। इसमें देखना है पहले फास्ट और सेकंड जो टाइप है स्लो अब इसमें हम आगे बढ़ते हैं और सबसे पहले ये देखते हैं कि है क्या चीज़ कोडिंग। एक हमने ऐसे लाइन खींची, ठीक है, दिस इज टाइम टी, रेफरेंस टाइम टी है और सिग्नल कुछ इस तरीके से है। शुरू में स्मॉल पिक्स है, बाद में हाई पिक्स, फिर स्मॉल पिक्स, फिर स्मॉल पिक्स, फिर हाई पिक्स, फिर स्मॉल पिक्स, फिर नेगेटिव पिक्स, फिर हाई, फिर नेगेटिव पिक्स, फिर हाई, फिर पिक्स। फ्लक्चुएशंस की वजह से वी आर गेटिंग दिस टाइप ऑफ सिग्नल्स। तो ये सिग्नल्स हमको प्राप्त हुआ, ध्यान से देखिएगा, दिस इज दिस सिग्नल्स। तो ये जो नीचे की जो लाइन है, इस लाइन के जो नीचे की जो सिग्नल्स हैं, दिस इज द फेडिंग। अब ये कौन कौन सी फेडिंग है? जिसमें नीचे सबसे बड़ा पीक बना हुआ है, इसको हम कहेंगे डीप फेड। दिस इज कॉल्ड डीप फेड। और जो सिग्नल्स नीचे की तरफ आया हुआ है, ये है फेडिंग की पावर की वजह से, यानी कि पावर ऑफ एंड दिस ऑल आर दी फेडिंग। दिस ऑल आर दी फेडिंग्स। सो इस फेडिंग प्रोसेस विच कॉजेस the received power to vary in wireless If H is Barry, the response of channel is Barry due to multipath signals are varies from the different time distances in a different time arrival. So quality of your received power is also vary. So quality of received power varies. The question is why cause significant impact on the nature of the destructive and constructive interference. And this is we already know in a two-ray light model, you can say if this is the tower और नेपाल नेम करेंगे तो इसकी ट्रांसमीटर एंड दिस इज द अब्स्ट्रक्ट स्ट्रकल्स ट्रीज हेयर our mobile receiver so you can see If the rays are directly fell on this receiver, it is known as line of sight, LOS. सिग्नल अगर डायरेक्ट इस पे जा रहा है तो ये लाइन ऑफ साइट पे है, अगर सिग्नल्स इसकी वजह से मल्टी पाथ जा रहा है दैट इज नॉन लाइन ऑफ साइट NLOS, और अगर सिग्नल्स किसी बिल्डिंग टॉल्स की वजह से रिफ्लेक्ट होके जा रहा है तो दैट इज आल्सो non-line of sight. So this is the multipath, creating the multipath. यहाँ पे इस receiver पे multiple signals components मिल रहे हैं. Multiple signals and it is the arrival of signals in a different distances. So if you look this is the environment. So it is the multipath propagation environment. ये जो बीच का जो यहाँ से यहाँ तक का है it is the मल्टी पाथ प्रोपगेशन एनवायरनमेंट. Yeah, you can say specific environment which having the obstacles, different types of obstacle. Due to this multipath environment, we are getting the interference. And in the mobile receiver, the superposition of all the multiple signals are received. So due to interference we are getting two types of combined signals. One is the constructive interference for another one is the destructive interference. In a constructive interference, amplitude amplitudes of received received signal in a destructive attenuation attenuate received signal so we developed the developed a real-life model for multipath consider the channel and wireless system. Transmitter has a signal, input signal x of t and which passes through the wireless environment, that is the channel. Wireless channels, which gives the output y of t so this channel having the response given by h of t हेमत पार्ट ऑफ वायरलेस Pacific Environment Cluttered characterized by delay tau of Attonation Attonation सो अगर हम मॉडल करें डिले और एटोनेशंस को तो मॉडलिंग के बाद ये आएगा ए एफ एम एंड डेल्टा टी माइनस टाउ ऑफ ये होगा पल्स by tau of तो अगर हम देखें मल्टीपल फैक्ट पैरामीटर्स में एम एम जीरो टू माइनस फोर, सो जीरो वन एंड माइनस वन कंपोनेंट हो जाएंगे ए नॉट टाउ नॉट और इंपल्स शिफ्ट हो जाएगा ये हो जाएगा ए नॉट सिग्मा टाउ टी माइनस टाउ ऑफ वन, ये हो जाएगा ए वन A1, tau1, A1, impulse shift, T, minus, tau1, ऐसे ही M, minus 1, डेल्टा टी माइनस टाउ और दिस इज द मल्टीपल पाथ response इसीलिए इसको हम कहेंगे ये sum of individual so h of t is equal to a of naught delta tau minus tau naught plus A1 delta T minus tau 1 and M minus 1 delta tau m minus 1. और ये जो होगा ये मेरा चैनल का रिस्पांस होगा, इसको हम लिख सकते हैं रिजल्ट को M is 0 to this is L minus 1. तो वैल्यू हो जाएगी a की पावर m डेल्टा t माइनस tau T of T is pulse response of चैनल। अलग अलग देखेंगे ट्रांसमीटर transmitted signal. Here, speed of L we are choosing R, here M, and here R. So transmit it. Signal is pass band signal, pass that is given by signal S of P. And two pi FC T modulated signal. So it is given by S of PT is equal to real part of of t and product of modulated so this is bad signal the complex complex baseband signal and this is the carrier frequency this real part A naught S of T minus tau naught so e to the power j 2 pi fc not so first part kya hoga
So first part. Then master pro तो ये इक्वेशन नाउ यू कैन राइट एस ऑफ माइनस टाउ आर माइनस वन ब्रैकेट क्लोज ए की पावर जे टू पाई एफ सी tau so radius Various multiple component. Band signal is sum of all multipath component so we write y of p in terms of t summation of n is equal to r minus 1 r e a of m s of t minus tau m. E to the power j 2 pi fc t minus tau write this equation r e bahar le lo for summation under here m is equal to 0 r minus 1 sigma m s t of I tau of and e to the power minus so this is the complex so ये हो गया मेरा क्या है equal to sigma I sigma I equal to 0 r minus 1 a of m So this is the complex is ये है मेरा माय बेस लाइन अगर सिंपलीफाई करें वी हैव सिंपलीफाइड दिस इक्वेशन वी गेट सम सॉल्यूशंस एस टी माइनस टाउ ऑफ एम इज नथिंग बट S of T, that is the narrow band.
So kya hoga? This is given a maximum frequency, but this given the carrier frequency. Maximum frequencies is very less than carrier frequencies. Yeah. So y of t is equal to summation of m is equal to 0 to r minus 1. So a of m s of t e to the power minus j into 2 pi fc formula sigma m is 0 to r minus 1 m e to the power minus j 2 pi fc tau m r into of t. So this is a complex coefficient. Now that is h of, so h is sigma m is 0 r minus 1 0 a of m e to the power minus j 2 pi fc So write y of t h is equal to h is a यहाँ पे तो आपको ये formula H depends on the patronation delay of h depends on the attenuation and the delay of the different multipath components. Different multi path
components. Sigma M is 0, zero M is 0 to 1, A of M, A की पावर माइनस J, 2 पाई, F C, tau of M. So opening the expression, A naught, E की पावर माइनस J, by FC tau of M plus A 1 e की power minus J 2 pi FC tau of M. Now assume that A naught A 1 is 1 tau naught 0 tau 1 upon twice of FC. So put tau 0, tau 1. A naught की value 1 e की power minus j 2 pi fc tau naught 0 plus a 1 e की power minus j 2 pi fc tau into 1 upon twice of FC. So this FC cancelled and e की power 0 plus 1 dot e की power minus j 2 cancel by. So this is 1 and this is also 1 comma minus 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. So H is 0. So this is the destructive are n, because components are traveling like this way, and electric field and magnetic field. So these are all components are in phase, so they cancel to each other. So due to cancellation, this is coming in the form of diffractive interference. They attenuate all the signals, and then all the signals are like this way. So putting this value, y of t is equal to h s of t. So what is the our signal? H is here 0. We got 0 dot s of t. So all the various multiple components are attenuate. We're getting 0 of signals. Now see, if assume A naught and A 1 is 1, T naught is 0, and tau naught is 0, tau 1 is 1 upon fc. So H is equal to summation of M is equal to 0 R minus 1 A of M E of minus J 2 pi F C tau of M. So equations are when K is 2, R is 2, when R is 2, so we're getting the two components, 1 A naught e to power minus j 2 pi fc tau of 1 plus A 1 e to power minus j 2 pi fc into tau of tau 0 and tau 1. So 1 into e to power minus j 2 pi fc multiplied by 0 plus A1 e to power minus j 2 pi fc into 1 upon fc, or A1 यहाँ पे one, so we are getting the 1 into e to power 0 plus 1 here cancel over, so I got e to power minus j 2 pi. So h is 1 plus is
2. Wait.
Analysis the signal amplitude at receiver. Therefore, depends on a attenuation and delay function. The coefficient varies depending on the various channels. A of M delays tau of M. So H is equal to sigma M is equal to 0 R minus 1. A 2 pi FC tau of M. So it is the fading channel coefficient. So plotting the channel coefficient with respect to time, that is नीचे का इस लाइन के नीचे सब फेडिंग्स है. सो दिस इज द पावर ऑफ फेडिंग. Fading coefficient H. This is D fed. So thank you very much.